good morning and welcome to another episode of Kids Church. My name is Jolie. I hope you're having a great morning today. Before we begin our lesson, we are going to start off with a song, so get ready to sing. Welcome back. So we are going to begin our lesson of the miracles of Jesus in the Bible. Today's story is Jesus calls his first disciples, and it comes to us from Luke chapter 5, verses 1 through 11. One day as Jesus was standing by the lake of Gennesaret, the people were crowding around him and listening to the word of God. He saw at the water's edge two boats left there by the fishermen who were washing their nets. He got into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, and asked them to put out a little from shore. Then he sat down and taught the people from the boat. When he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into deep water and let down the nets for a catch." Simon answered, "Master, we've worked hard all night and haven't caught anything. But because you say so, I will let down the nets." When they had done so, they caught such a large number of fish that their nets began to break. So they signaled their partners in the other boat to come and help them. And they came and filled both boats so full that they began to sink. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at Jesus' knees and said, "Go away from me, Lord. I am a sinful man." For he and all his companions were astonished at the catch of fish they had taken. And so were James and John, the sons of Zebedee, Simon's partners. Then Jesus said to Simon, "Don't be afraid. From now on, you will fish for people." So they pulled their boats up on shore, left everything, and followed him. So this disciple is about Jesus calling on his first disciples. So a disciple is a follower of a leader. And in this story, he had told Simon to let down their nets so they can catch fish. But Simons' first response was they had thought of this idea and did it, and they failed. But because he said so, they were going to do it. So it shows how Simon had belief and respect for the leader, Jesus, but at the same time didn't believe in his idea since he told him they did it already and it didn't work. But of course, Jesus knows better than we do, and they caught so much fish that two boats were going to sink because of how much fish they caught. So Simon dropped to his knees and told Jesus that he was a sinful man because he should have faith since he was a disciple of Jesus. But Jesus, of course, doesn't get mad at us, but instead teaches us a lesson and said that they should now fish for other people. So it says they pulled their boats on shore, left everything, and followed him. So my question to you is, are you able to drop everything and follow Jesus and what he says? Now, that's a big thing to think about, but throughout the Bible, that's what Jesus teaches us, and it shows you how after each time he does this crazy miracle throughout the Bible of healing other people and helping other people, only then are people willing to believe in him 100% and do everything that he says. But at the same time, it's a good thing because we continue to spread the message of God. So it's our duty to be the people of the disciples and to fish around and spread the word of God. So that's why we go to church and why we continue to watch these videos, is because we're spreading the love. I am spreading the love and the word of God to you. And I hope you do the same thing of telling your siblings or your friends or your parents and just spreading the word. You can spread the links of all the kids' church sermons and the sermons of Pastor Bob, and just continue to spread all of these messages. You can even just share the story or read the Bible yourself. It's nothing harmful. It's something good that we do. We spread kindness, we spread love, and we spread all of these beautiful miracles that Jesus does. So that is the moral of this story, and I hope you take that to heart and to your mind and continue to spread kindness, all these beautiful miracles that we've learned throughout the past weeks, and love. So I hope you guys are ready for our activity. So for today's craft, we are going to need crayons or markers, a Ziploc bag, a piece of paper, a pair of scissors, a Sharpie or black marker, some water in a glass, and anything that can turn the water blue. So I didn't have any color or dye, so I just used my blue soap. You just need a little bit. So we're going to take our black marker and start to make lines on the Ziploc bag like this. And what we're doing is we are creating a fishnet. So now we're going to take our piece of paper with some crayons or markers, and you're just going to draw fishes. So you can draw as many as you want and whatever color you'd like, but try to make them pretty large in size. Now we can cut them out. So here comes the messy part. We're going to open the Ziploc bag and carefully put in water inside of it. It doesn't have to be a lot. And then we're going to go ahead and add the blue dye, color, soap, whatever you have to change the color of the water. Also, but if you don't have anything to change the color of the water, it's completely fine. It's just to mimic the ocean. So now you can go ahead and add all of the fishes inside. Don't forget to close the Ziploc bag, and this is what happens when the disciples listened to Jesus, set out their nets, and they were able to catch many fish. Hi guys, so I hope you had fun making today's activity. I hope you take this as a reminder that Jesus has the right intentions in our lives when he tells us to do things, and we should have full faith and belief that he is there to do great things in our lives. And just remember that it is up to us to fish out to more people, to spread the love of Jesus, all of these beautiful stories we know and beliefs about him, and to just remember to be kind, because we are a huge community that loves and believes in Jesus. So I hope you guys had a great time with me today. I hope you have a great weekend, and I hope you're ready for the last song. So I'll see you guys next week. Bye.
I've got